हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल प्रोग्रामिंग इन माय वे। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इंटरफेस इन जावा। सो इन लास्ट सेशन वी हैव कवर्ड मेथड ओवरलोडिंग, मेथड ओवरराइडिंग, गेटिंग एंड यू नो दैट दीज आर द पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म फीचर्स ऑफ जावा, गेटिंग। सो मेथड ओवरराइडिंग, मेथड ओवरलोडिंग, दे कम्स अंडर पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म फीचर ऑफ जावा, ओके। And interface. So this interface concept is used to achieve the abstraction. So you know that like polymorphism, abstraction, data abstraction is also one of the important feature of object-oriented programming. So to achieve this data abstraction, interface is used in Java. Okay. So interface concept was not there in C++ language, but it is there in Java. And in addition to achieving the abstraction in Java, it is also used to achieve the multiple inheritance in Java. So we have seen that at the time of inheritance, multiple inheritance through class, it is not possible in Java, but it is possible using interface in Java. So mainly this interface concept has two advantages. The first one is it is used to achieve the data abstraction in Java, and the second one is we can achieve the multiple inheritance in Java. So let us start with interface with the help of program. Okay. So it is a interface is a keyword. Interface is a keyword. So see what I am doing. I am taking one interface animal, and the interface, you know that class definition can have the variable declaration, getting. Those variables can be instance variables, static variables, getting. Here also we can declare the variables, getting. Here also we can declare the variables, and you know that in class we can have the method bodies, but in interface we don't have method bodies. Instead we are placing the method signatures only, getting. So two things we can place inside interface body, that is variable declaration and the method signature, variable declaration and method signature. And also there is some compulsory things we should know, that is the variables or the members, whatever members we are going to declare in interface, those variables are by default public, static and final, getting. So you should know this thing, that is the members or the variables we are declaring in interface, they are by default public, static and final. This is compulsory thing. Though, even though if you are not specifying the public, static and final keyword, that is automatically added by the compiler for your variable declaration. So remember this. And the second thing, suppose I'm adding the method signature for run method. Method signature for run method. So methods are always, the methods are always public and abstract. So the method, run method, is always public and abstract. Okay. So remember this. So these two things you should know. The members are always public, static and final, and methods are always public and abstract. Okay. So these two things are compulsory. Even though you are not specifying those keywords, public, static, final for variable, compiler will automatically add. And even though if you are not adding public abstract keyword for method, it will be automatically added by compiler, okay, for your method. So inside interface we can't place the body, because you know that abstraction is what? It is what? Hiding the internal details or hiding the implementation details and only showing the essential details to the user. So this interface concept is used to achieve the abstraction. So here, if you observe this, here we are only having the method signature. So this will be known by the user, and we are hiding the implementation detail of this run method, and that will be present in the class who is implementing this particular interface. So let us take the class. So see, I am taking dog class. Okay, dog class. So this dog class will implement the interface. So to make or to have this relationship with between class and interface, this relationship is achieved by using implements keyword. So we have seen extends keyword is there for inheritance. So for interface, implements keyword is there. For the class who is implementing interface, you should add the implements keyword. And what is the interface name? Animal. So see here what it indicates. The dog class is implementing the animal interface. So what is the meaning of this? Animal has some method, or animal has few methods which are implemented by this dog class. Getting? So animal has some method declaration whose bodies are present in dog class. So which method is present in interface? Run. So its a implementation is provided by dog class. Getting? So here I am simply printing the static message, getting, that is running. Okay, I'm not adding the big logic, just I'm printing here running message. And one more thing, see, as run method is by default public abstract method, getting, so here you should place public. Otherwise, if there is no access specifier specified for method, then that will be considered as a default access specifier. So default is having the low privilege and the public is having the high privilege. So there will be conflict. So that's why here you should mention the access specifier, because by default the access specifier is default. Getting? So there will be mismatch. So that's why remember that the method, whatever method you are implementing in class, there should be public, because it is declared inside interface and there is a public. Okay, so to avoid that conflict, you should declare here public also. Here public is not compulsory. We already discussed that. In interface, public is not compulsory. It will be automatically added by the compiler. So this is the interface and class. And now, see, I am taking the main class. Suppose I am taking interface demo. Okay, and then public static main, public static main. Okay, now see, if I want to call this run method, then I should create the object of dog class. Getting? Should create the object of dog class like this. Okay, and then I should call the run method by using the dog object, by using the dog object. So see, this is main class. Interface demo is main class. So I am saving this file with interface demo.java extension. Okay, so see the execution. There is a animal interface which has two things, size, this one. Okay, here I will place running with. See, here I will just mention 30. Here we'll print that size. Getting? So see, size, that is variable. See, size is a variable which is declared inside animal, and that is public static final variable. Okay, so we have initialized 30 value to that. So I have printed that value in run. It is accessible here, no problem. Getting? Because dog class is implementing the animal interface. Okay, so that is correct. And see, here we have created the object of dog class who is implementing the animal interface, and we have called the run method. So the it will call the run method, and this output will be printed, that is running with 30 size. So let us check the output, then we'll again discuss more on this. So So my source file is present in bin folder. Interface demo. Okay, so file is successfully compiled. And just see the output running with 30 kg, I mean to say. Getting? So this is what interface. So see, I'm explaining one more time. Interface is a something which is used to achieve two things in Java. First thing is abstraction, which is one of the important feature of object-oriented programming. And the second one is multiple inheritance we are achieving. So here, interface, you know that, abstraction, you know that. It is what? Hiding the implementation details and presenting only essential details to the user. So here we are presenting only the size and run to the user. That means we are just presenting the declaration of them. Getting? And we are hiding the implementation details. So we have written the run method implementation inside class. Okay, so that will be hidden from user. Okay, and we are only presenting it's a declaration that is present in interface. Okay, and dog class is implementing the animal interface. So there is a implements keyword for class and interface relationship. There should be implements keyword. Okay, so remember this. Okay, and as a run method body is present in dog class, so we should create the object of dog class. So we can't create the object of interface. Remember this, we can't instantiate the interface. So we can't call the object of animal A equal to new animal like this. We can't do that. So remember this. This is what interface for data abstraction. Now, how to achieve multiple inheritance? So I will modify the same program for multiple inheritance. Okay. So see what I'm doing. I'm taking animal one as interface. I'm taking two interfaces here. See animal one and animal two. See, I'm removing this size. I will make it simple. So void run method is there, and two interfaces I'm taking. So second interface I have taken, it is animal two, and see, I'm taking method eat method in animal two interface. So right now I'm having two interfaces, animal one interface, which has run method declaration, and second interface, that is animal two, which has eat method declaration. And then I'm taking the dog class, getting? And see what I'm doing. Dog is implementing both interfaces at a time. So class dog implements animal one and see animal two. So see, this was not possible in inheritance extends, and then we can't take animal one comma animal two, but for interface it is possible. And see, now I can have both method definitions here in this class. Okay, so I can place now system.out println. See, eating. So right now I will remove this. Okay, so see, run method is method of animal one. Okay, so it's a body is present in dog class, and eat method is method of animal two interface. Okay, so it's a body is also present, and see, I'm calling both methods. So what will be output? So see, d.run, this will call run method, and running method, running message will be printed on output screen. And then see, eat method will be called, so eating message will be printed on output screen. So let us see the output. So compile one more time and run. So see, running and eating. So this is what multiple inheritance using interface. Getting? So this is also possible. That means there is a one class and two interfaces. This is a, there is a one class and two interfaces are there. And in other way also, you can achieve multiple inheritors. There will be three interfaces. That is also possible. So I will show you. So same program I am modifying. See, I am taking one more interface called animal 3. I'm taking third interface animal 3, and see, I'm adding bark method there. Okay, so forget about this class now. See, three interfaces are there, and see, there is a relationship. Class can implement interface, you know that. Class can extend another class. Class can implement another interface. Getting? And third thing is there, one interface can extend another interface. So I am doing that thing here. So see what I am doing. Extends interface animal 3. Interface animal 3 extends both interfaces. So this is pure multiple inheritance. See, one interface is extending two interfaces. Getting? This I want to show. And suppose there is a class dog. So who is implementing animal 3 interface only, because it is already extending the animal 1 and animal 2. Okay, so see, three interfaces are there: animal 1, animal 2, animal 3. Getting? Animal 1, animal 2, animal 3. Animal 3 is extending the animal 1, animal 2. And all these interfaces have one method signature: run, eat, and bark. And then I am taking one class dog who is implementing animal 3. Animal 3 is in turn extending above both interfaces, animal 1, animal 2. And see, I am adding all the methods in class dog. So with this also, you can have or multiple inheritance is possible. So here is simply printing barking. So you can call bark method as well. D dot bark. So let us compile. See, running, eating, and barking. Okay, so see, this is pure multiple inheritance. One interface can extend more than one interfaces. One class can implement more than one interfaces. That is also possible. Getting? So by using interface, multiple inheritance can be achieved in Java. Remember this. By using class, it is not possible to achieve multiple inheritance. Getting? So this interface concept is very, very important concept in Java. Okay. So I hope you got the idea about interface. Okay. So if you like my video, then please like, comment, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel, Programming in My Way. Thank you.